Hi viewers, welcome to my YouTube channel. We are discussing performance of the transmission lines. In that I started with the short transmission lines. In this video I am going to explain a numerical problem on short transmission lines. Let me consider one example. An overhead three phase transmission line delivers 5000 kilowatt at 22 kV at 0.8 power factor lagging. The resistance and reactance of each conductor is 4 ohm and 6 ohm respectively. Determine sending end voltage, percentage regulation, transmission efficiency. Okay. So in this one three phase short transmission line is given. In that they mentioned receiving end power, receiving end voltage, receiving end power factor and line resistance and reactance. Both are given, then we have to calculate the sending end voltage, percentage regulation and transmission efficiency. So first write given data. So here I am taking given data. So first power delivered is given. So that I am taking PD. PD is equal to how much? 5000 kilowatt. So after that receiving end voltage is given. So receiving end voltage VR is equal to 22 kV. In volts it is 22,000 volts. So now I am converting this into per phase values. So in the question they mentioned three phase transmission line, right? So but I am converting this into phase value. So therefore receiving end voltage per phase wing end voltage per phase is equal to this value is line value and I am converting this line value into phase value. To get phase value just divide this with root 3. So therefore 22,000 by root 3. So if you do it in calc, you will get 22,000 by root 3 is equal to 12,701. So that is equal to 12,701 volts. So therefore receiving end voltage per phase is equal to 12,701 volts. So after that power factor value also given. Power factor is cos pi r, that value is 0.8 lagging value is given. Next after that they mentioned resistance value. Resistance is equal to 4 ohm and reactance value is 6 ohm. So therefore we can write a line impedance is equal to R plus J XL form, that is 4 plus J 6. Okay, total line impedance is equal to 4 plus J 6. So this is the given data. Now we want to calculate sending end voltage, percentage regulation and transmission efficiency. Okay, so we have equation for sending end voltage. So what is the sending end voltage formula? So to get sending end voltage, we have a relation Vs is equal to Vr plus I into Z. Okay, so here Vr value is given, Z value is given. So first calculate the current I value. If you calculate the current I value, then calculation of sending end voltage will become easy, right? So therefore first calculate the current I value. So now I am going to calculate the current I value, line current value. So we know that in three phase system power delivered is equal to 3 into Vr I cos pi r. Okay, so from this I is equal to power delivered by 3 into Vr cos pi r. So substitute all the values. So your PD is equal to 5000 kilowatts are given, so therefore multiplying it with 10 cube. Next V 3 into VR value, just now we calculated. I am taking per phase value 12,701 into power factor value is 0.8. Power factor value is 0.8. So now solve this one. How much you will get? 5000 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by 3 into 12701 into 0.8, 164.02. So therefore I am taking 164. So therefore current I is equal to 164 amperes. Current I is equal to 164 amperes. Next, to draw the phasor diagram. So in this I am taking VR as a reference vector. So take VR as a reference vector. So I am taking VR on x axis. So this is the VR vector. So here load is given, that is inductive load, means lagging power factor load is given. So therefore for lagging power factor loads, current lags the voltage by some less than 90 degrees. So here that angle is phi R and this vector is I. So after that resistance drop, IR drop, that is in phase with the current I. So therefore I am taking a parallel line for I. So this vector become IR. So next coming to the IXL drop, so that is perpendicular to the IR. Perpendicular to the IR. So this is the IXL drop. So then resultant of these three is sending end voltage VS. Sending end voltage VS. So this is the VS. Okay. So angle between I and VS is, angle between I and VS is pi S. Sending end power factor angle. So this is the phasor diagram. So now see here. First we taken VR as our reference. So therefore VR bar is equal to, VR bar is equal to, so if it is reference vector, then consider VR plus J0, because it is at an angle of 0, right? So then substitute the VR value here, per phase value here I am taking. So VR is equal to 12701 plus J0. So this is VR is equal to. So similarly I am writing the current vector, current I is equal to, so to get this just multiply current value with cos pi R minus J sin pi R. Okay, so here cos pi R value is given, so by that we can calculate the sin pi R value. So first substitute current I value, how much current we got? 164 into cos pi R value is 0.8 minus J. So if cos pi R is 0.8, then sin pi R become 0.6. okay, so now solve this one, you will get the current vector. One sixty four into zero point eight is 131.2 minus J 164 into 0.6. So how much it is? 98.4. So therefore I bar is equal to 132.2 minus J 94.8. So this is I bar is equal to. Now calculate sending end voltage per phase. Okay, so sending end voltage per phase value. Sending end voltage per phase is equal to, we know that VS bar is equal to VR bar plus I bar Z bar. So substitute these values. So here VR bar is equal to 12701 plus J0. I am not taking the J0. Next I bar, just now we calculated, that is 131.2 minus J 98.4. So after that Z value is given, how much it is? 4 plus J6. Okay. So now see here, in second term we have to multiply the two numbers, but two are in rectangular form. So therefore to multiply, convert these two numbers into polar forms. So in next step, I am converting that two numbers into polar forms. So first I am converting 131.2 minus J98.4 to the polar form. So to convert, just press shift plus 131.2 comma minus 98.4. How much it is? 164 at an angle of minus 36.86. Okay. Next convert 4 plus J6 into polar form. Same procedure. Shift plus 4 comma 6. So how much it is? 7.211 at an angle of 56.30. Right. So 12,701, this is same. Plus multiply these two numbers. So in multiplication, just multiply magnitudes separately. What are the magnitudes here? 164 into 7.211. Okay. 164 into 7.211. So how much it is? 1182.604. And add the angles. So just add the angles. First angle is minus 36.86 plus 56.30. How much it is? 19.44. Okay. So now see here. So one is in rectangular form, another one is polar form. So convert this into rectangular form because we have to add two numbers, right? So 12,701 is same. Now I am converting this number into rectangular form. So to convert into rectangular form, just press shift minus, shift minus 1182.604 comma angle is 19.44. So therefore x value is nothing but real part value, that is 115.18, plus y value is imaginary part value, so that is j into 393.59. So now add the real parts separately and imaginary parts separately. So here 12,701 plus this term. So how much it is? 12,701 plus 1115.18. So therefore 13,816.18 plus imaginary part is same, 393.59. So therefore sending end voltage is equal to 13,816.18 plus J393.59. Okay. So this is the sending end voltage. Now I want magnitude of the sending end voltage. To get the magnitude of sending end voltage, just convert this into polar form. So I am converting this into polar form. Shift plus 13,816.18, 393.59. Okay. So therefore the magnitude value is 13,821.78 at an angle of 1.63. Okay, so this is the magnitude of the sending end voltage. So what is the magnitude? Magnitude of Vs is how much it is? 13,821.71. This is at an angle of 1.63. Okay, so therefore Vs. So if you want to consider only magnitude, that is 13,821 volts. Okay, so this is the sending end voltage. Next I am calculating the line voltage. So this is the sending end voltage per phase value, right? So if you want line voltage, just multiply this with root 3. So that means root 3 into Vs. So if you multiply this with root 3. So just I am considering the magnitude here, root 3 into root 3 into 13,821. So how much it is? 23,938.67 volts. So line voltage is 23,938 volts, right? So next we want a percentage regulation, right? So calculate the percentage regulation. Percentage regulation is equal to, what is the formula? So formula is Vs minus Vr by Vr. Vs minus Vr by Vr. So just to substitute the values, so I am taking here per phase values only. So first, what is the Vs value? So just here we calculated 13,821 minus Vr value. So what is the Vr value? Vr per phase value I want. So Vr per phase is equal to how much it is? So we calculated. What is the Vr per phase value? 12,701 by Vr per phase. 12,701. So to get percentage, just multiply this with 100. To get percentage, just multiply this with 100. So now what is the percentage regulation here? 13,821 minus 12,701 divided by 12,701 into 100. So therefore percentage regulation is equal to 8.818%. So this is the percentage regulation value. Percentage regulation value. So next we want to calculate transmission efficiency. So to get the transmission efficiency, we want to know what is the power delivered and power sent. So already they given power delivered. So to get power sent value, so first we have to know what are the transmission line losses. Okay, to get the efficiency, first to calculate transmission line losses. So in next step I am going to calculate transmission line losses. So line losses. So in three phase system, what is the formula for line losses? 3 into I square R. 3 into I square R. Right. So therefore substitute the values. 3 into I square value. Just I am taking magnitude value. So I value is 164 square. And R value is how much they given? For R value 4. So now calculate this one. Three into 164 whole square into 4. So 322,752 watts. So in kilowatts it is 322.752 kilowatts. So transmission line losses is equal to 322.752 kilowatts. Okay. So then calculate the transmission line efficiency. Right. So transmission line efficiency is equal to transmission efficiency is equal to power delivered by power sent into 100. This is the formula. So a power delivered value is given. So to get power sent, then take power delivered plus total losses. Okay, so I am using this formula, power delivered by power delivered plus total losses into 100. So next, so transmission efficiency is equal to power delivered is 5000 by power delivered 5000 plus total losses. So what are the total losses? 322.752 into 100 into 100. So solve this one. 5000 divided by 5000 plus 322.752 into 100. So therefore transmission line efficiency is 93.93%. Transmission efficiency is 93.93%. Thank you.